14th hole. Looking balanced on the end of that swing there. If Karl stays in balance, it's generally going to be straight down the middle.
Well, that flag there doesn't show it, but this wind's come right in now. That flag is protected by the trees behind it, so Karl's going to be hitting a one iron. Going to have to be a stinger because he's on an upslope, and the upslope's going to be involved. I'd be surprised if he gets out. I think he's the upslope here. That's a good shot. Good shot. Putting for eagle. Just how close it is, don't know. I'm going to cover the eagle putt. It's a pretty good second shot there because he was straight into the wind. That flag's not moving there because of the wind's behind the green. The trees behind the green are stuck in the wind. But, good shot by Karl, but one heck of a shot by Gareth Patterson, the guy in the blue. Just there, he put his 3-wood to about 5 feet. Don't go leaving your eagle quite short, bud. Golly, laying it up to make sure you get your birdie. Balance. That's a huge drive by Karl. Fine. Karl for birdie putt number 9. He's gotta start converting a few.
Got a chance. Ah. Left edge. Just nearly lipped it. Nearly went in.
Karl's missed the fairway to the right off the tee. The old one arm off the club follow through. Let's see if we can get the ball flight here. He needs to cut this. I'd say he's overcut that. That blade. Yeah, well out.
that's what we call a pull. Good speed. Rip it and rip it. 16 off straight into the breeze. Second shot on 16. Should be good. Oh yeah. Hope it stayed on the green. Just hung on to that one. That last hole, Karl swung a lot easier with his drive there. Wind coming off the right, very strong. Green. Right, dirty putt, but two putts would be just dandy. It's a good shot in the green. What Karl found out about this green is that if you go long, you can kiss par goodbye because it's downhill all the way to the hole. But anyway, here we go.
This is my one iron stinger. I'm just working on something with my coach, so bear the takeaway. I know a lot of you didn't think I had a one iron, but I do. But anyways, that's not the point of this video. It's just a wrap up of the, you know, this 3-day pro-am thing I had for the Victorian PGA. If you don't know what that is, you have a partner which is a pro, and I'm the amateur, and there were over 60 teams, and it's a net based tournament. Unfortunately, it's not stroke. I don't think they really do stroke play for any of these pro-am events, but it was net, so. Best stroke score doesn't necessarily win. Usually it's the higher handicapper group that wins. But My partner, Michael Wright, he played pretty good for the tournament. I think he was 6 under for the tournament, or 5 under. But we were 16 under total, which didn't even come close. We probably got over top 20, but 31 under one. Couldn't really do much about that unless we both shot like 63 on the rounds. But it was a pretty, very nice track. Greens were pure. Obviously it wasn't as good as the way it would be for the Australian Masters when they, greens in that tournament, apparently, because the guy, my partner Michael, played in it. Apparently it was very firm greens, a lot faster fairways, and there wasn't fringe. It was just green and then bunkers. So a lot tougher, but I thought I played pretty good second round, first round okay, and last round not so great. But it was a lot of fun just to get the experience of playing a pro event. I also like to thank the PGA of Australia for getting me the invite, and I had a lot of fun being around the being inside the ropes. But hopefully I can do more of these. Now the one iron stinger I hit wasn't actually a stinger. I actually forgot to hit a stinger. So this one is going to be a stinger. I got to kind of get the weight through a little bit. That was a stinger. The one iron actually isn't that hard to hit. You gotta have some distance to pick the club. If you hit it like 150 yards, then there's not really a point. But I like it. I can really compress it. It's like my 3 iron. It's an ultimate driving iron. Very hollow. You can really compress it, and it's only got, I think, 15 degrees of loft. So I can hit it low against the wind, and it goes without wind probably 240 to 250. I struggled to hit it off the tee for some reason, but I'm working on that. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the tournament, and I know I did. So see you guys soon.